In this video, we will see an example of a NEET PG 2021 pattern question. So there will be a clinical question like this with a good amount of content. A 36-year-old female patient presents to the surgery OPD with pain abdomen and diarrhea since 3 days. She is a known case of some GI disease for which she is on regular treatment. She also gave history of on and off episodes of similar complaint. On examination, the patient had pain in the right lower quadrant. Initially, an erect radiograph of the abdomen was done, followed by which the patient was subjected a CT scan. Within a couple of days, she underwent a surgical procedure to excise the bowel segment. The radiograph, a section of the CT, the picture of the surgical specimen, and an image of a histopathological appearance are given below. Which of the following signs will not be radiological seen in the case? That means you are given a complete clinical scenario along with the investigation that have been performed. These are the images that are given along with the case. You have a radiograph, you have a barium study, you have CT scan, a surgical specimen, and pathology. Okay. Now what you could see is a irregular narrowing in the region of the terminal ileum as well as in the region of the duodenum. On CT, you see differential enhancement in the region of the terminal ileum. The surgical specimen reveal some of the polyps in the, or you can say pseudo polyps into the specimen. Now let us go back and to the question. So now the question is pointing towards the diagnosis of an inflammatory bowel disease. The two important diseases that we have are the Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Our question is, which of the following signs will not be radiological seen in the given case? So now a differential enhancement involvement of the duodenum and the terminal ileum points towards a diagnosis of Crohn's disease. Though pseudopolyps are more commonly a feature of ulcerative colitis, but they can be seen in Crohn's disease. Involvement of the duodenum and differential enhancement is also favoring that. A combination of longitudinal and transverse ulcer separating intact portion of mucosa is a feature of Crohn's disease. Small discrete round filling defect within the lumen of the bowel on barium study, a link, again Crohn's disease. Fissuring deep penetrating thorn-like ulcers in thickened bowel wall, again Crohn's disease. Fine mucosal granularity in the barium study, which further progresses to coarseness. Now this is a feature of ulcerative colitis, and hence the answer of this is D. That is not a typical radiological feature in the given case. So the whole idea is that if you look at the question, it does not belong to a particular subject. It will have a linked information from medicine, pathology, radiology. All these will be clubbed and will be given to you. So make sure that you are preparing well with this kind of pattern.